Hey guys, welcome to Precious Medlage. I hope you all are doing good and have watched my previous videos. If not, what are you waiting for? Go for those after the end of this video. Now, without wasting any time further, let's get into today's topic. So today's topic is COVID-19 associated mucormycosis, that is CAM. Okay, so first let's discuss about mucormycosis. So mucormycosis is basically a fungal infection which is caused by mucorales, that is mucormycetes. So coming to the incidence, in India, right now there is a very high incidence of mucormycosis seen among COVID-19 patients, especially who are diabetic and are on steroids and immunosuppressants. CAM is associated with very high morbidity and mortality. Mucormycosis is one of the most devastating complications seen in uncontrolled diabetes patients. So the single most important risk factor for the development of invasive mucormycosis is uncontrolled glycemic status, that is uncontrolled diabetes. Okay, now coming to the pathogenesis of CAM. As I have already mentioned, the strongest predisposing factor is hyperglycemia, that is uncontrolled glycemic status seen in uncontrolled diabetes. So this hyperglycemia leads to polymorphonuclear dysfunction, impaired chemotaxis, that is impaired movement of the white blood cells basically towards a chemical stimulus to the site of infection, and there is defective intracellular killing. Okay, so mucorales acquire iron from the host, which is needed for their growth, and in conditions like ketoacidosis, which is a complication of diabetes mellitus, free iron becomes readily available in our serum. So as a result, the mucorales will be able to acquire the iron which is required for their growth, and this process is also greatly amplified with the help of immunosuppressants. So the patients who are on immunosuppressants, there this process will be amplified. Okay, as a result, the mucorales will be able to grow. Now coming to the mode of spread of mucormycosis. Mucormycosis is not a contagious disease, that is it doesn't spread from contact. So it doesn't spread from person to person. The fungal spores enter our respiratory tract via air. So respiratory tract is the route by which the fungal spores enter in our body. Now coming to the classification of CAM, that is COVID-19 associated mucormycosis, it can be concomitant, that is occurring with COVID-19 infection, or sequential, that is which is occurring after the recovery from COVID-19 infection. Based on the clinical presentation, CAM is classified into the following types, that is rhino-orbito-cerebral mucormycosis, pulmonary type, gastrointestinal type, disseminated type, and primary cutaneous type. Out of this, we are going to discuss rhino-orbito-cerebral mucormycosis, that is ROCM, and primary mucormycosis. So the presentation of ROCM, you can easily remember that, because rhino means nose. So nasal blockade and nasal congestion will be there. Along with that, there will be facial pain, palpebral swelling, conjunctival congestion, that is reddish eyes, ptosis, that is drooping of the upper eyelid, and loss of vision. Okay. Along with that, we are having cerebral involvement. So along that, we can have headache, plus we can also have focal seizures, alter sensorium, etc. Okay, orbital pain is also there, toothache is also there. Now coming to the warning symptoms and signs of ROCM. So first is epistaxis, that is bleeding from the nose, purulent or blood tinged nasal discharge, periocular or facial pain, worsening headache, orbital pain, sudden loss of vision, diplopia, that is double vision, altered sensorium, that is a feature of cerebral involvement, and focal seizures. So these two you can remember from cerebral. Okay, epistaxis, rhino, this also rhino. Along with that, orbital involvement is there, so orbital pain is there, then periocular edema is also there, so from that you can remember orbital involvement. Okay, now coming to the clinical features of pulmonary mucormycosis, it includes fever, cough, chest pain, pleural effusion, and hemoptysis, that is coughing out blood. Now coming to the diagnosis, the suspected patients should undergo MRI PNS, that is paranasal sinus, along with brain contrast study for ROCM, and plain CT thorax for pulmonary mucormycosis. Diagnosis is confirmed by fungal staining and culture from the collected specimens. So these specimens are collected by the ENT surgeon in case of ROCM, that is mainly the debrided tissue, by endoscopic method. And in pulmonary mucormycosis, CT guided biopsy for lung and bronchoalveolar lavage is used to collect the specimens. Now coming to the treatment of CAM. Mucormycosis is a medical emergency, so the patients should be started on an empirical therapy even before the diagnosis is being confirmed. So the treatment of CAM is a multidisciplinary approach, that is many departments are involved, that is ENT department, ophthalmology department, then physician, then intensivist, so many departments are involved here. So first, we should control the diabetes and diabetic ketoacidosis. Then we should reduce the steroids if the patient is still on it. We should discontinue immunomodulatory drugs in these patients. Then extensive surgical debridement must be done to remove all the necrotic material. Suppose the eye is involved, so we may have to excentrate the eye, that is removal of the eyeball and the surrounding tissues, that is eyelids, muscles, nerves and fatty tissue which are lying adjacent to the eye. Coming to the medical management, first insert a central venous catheter, maintain adequate hydration in the patient and start antifungal therapy. So the antifungal of choice is liposomal amphotericin B, given 5 mg per kg per day, diluted in 200 cm cube of 5% dextrose and is given over 2 to 3 hours infusion. And it is given for 3 to 6 weeks. 10 mg per kg per day is used in case there is brain involvement. And along with that, you have to monitor the renal function and potassium levels while treating with amphotericin B. In patients who are not tolerating amphotericin B, we can give posaconazole or isavuconazole as injection or tablets. And we also have to monitor the patients clinically, microbiologically and with radio imaging to look for the response to the treatment. Now coming to the prevention of CAM. For prevention, good glycemic control, the most important thing during management of COVID-19 patients is required. Steroids should be administered only as per indications, that is no overuse should be done. Then patients at risk like uncontrolled diabetics, then long-term steroid patients and COVID-19 patients should avoid construction sites, because construction sites are full of fungal spores. Universal masking, that is everyone should wear mask, should be strictly practiced. Then strict aseptic precautions must be taken while administering oxygen to COVID-19 patients. As you know, mucormycosis, which is caused by mucorales, spread through the air and the route is respiratory tract. During discharge of COVID-19 treated patients, make them aware of the early symptoms of mucormycosis and ask them to report if they develop one. This is a very important step. Then we have to also do quantification of the fungal spores in the ICUs, that is intensive care units, because the COVID-19 patients may acquire the infection from ICU itself. Now, before ending the topic, one important fact, mucorales causing mucormycosis are not black fungi, which is a misconception which everyone is having. So with this, we will complete the topic of COVID-19 associated mucormycosis. Now let's revise. So first, coming to incidence, in India, the incidence is increasing day by day and seen mainly in COVID-19 patients who are either diabetic or they are on steroids or immunosuppressants. It is associated with high morbidity and mortality, most commonly seen in uncontrolled diabetes patients. So hyperglycemia is the most important risk factor. As you know, pathogenesis I have already mentioned. Hyperglycemia leads to polymorphonuclear dysfunction, impaired chemotaxis and defective intracellular killing. And mucorales have the ability to acquire iron from the host, and in conditions like diabetic ketoacidosis, which is a complication of diabetes mellitus, free iron becomes easily available in our serum. So as a result, this will help the mucorales, and this process is greatly amplified if the patient is on immunosuppressants. Spread. Mucormycosis is a non-contagious disease, and the route of entry of the fungal spores is via the respiratory tract. Classification I have already mentioned, one which occurs along with the COVID-19 infection and one which occurs after the COVID-19 infection, that is concomitant and sequential. And based on clinical presentation, we have five. In that, the most important is rhino-orbito-cerebral mucormycosis and pulmonary mucormycosis. Rhino-orbito-cerebral means, rhino means nose. So you can have nasal blockage, nasal congestion, then purulent discharge from the nose, then epistaxis, that is bleeding from the nose. Orbital means there can be orbital pain, then orbital involvement, like along with that we can have ptosis, that is drooping of the upper eyelid, then conjunctival congestion, etc. Cerebral means there can be headache, there can be worsening of the headache, then there can be ultrasensorium and focal seizures. And sudden loss of vision is also a warning sign in rhino-orbito-cerebral mucormycosis. Coming to the pulmonary mucormycosis, the clinical features of pulmonary mucormycosis will be cough, fever, chest pain, pleural effusion, and hemoptysis, that is coughing out blood. Diagnosis, we have to do MRI, PNS, that is paranasal sinus, along with brain contrast study and plain CT thorax in case of pulmonary mucormycosis. Diagnosis is confirmed by fungal culture and staining. Specimens are obtained endoscopically, also by bronchoalveolar lavage. So, treatment of CAM, it is a medical emergency, so we had to start the treatment even before the diagnosis is being confirmed. And the treatment is a multidisciplinary approach, that is many departments are involved here. First, we have to control diabetes, diabetic ketoacidosis. We have to reduce the dosage of steroids. We have to stop immunomodulatory drugs. Then we have to do extensive surgical debridement of the necrotic material. Excentration has to be done if the eye is involved severely. Then medical management includes antifungal therapy. In antifungal therapy, we are preferring liposomal amphotericin B 5 mg per kg per day, and it is to be given as 10 mg per kg per day if there is brain involvement. Monitor the renal function along with that. If the patient is not tolerating amphotericin B, then we can give posaconazole or we can also give isavuconazole. Okay. Then prevention of CAM, good glycemic control is the most important thing. Steroids should not be overused. Next is, if the patient is a high-risk patient, then they should avoid construction sites because they are having a large concentration of the fungal spores. Universal masking is very important because the route of entry is the respiratory tract. Okay. Then aseptic precautions has to be taken while administering oxygen to the COVID-19 patients, and during discharge of the COVID-19 patients, we should also make the patient aware of the symptoms of mucormycosis and ask them to report back if they develop one. Quantification of fungal spores in the intensive care units has to be done. And last is the important fact which I have already mentioned, that is mucormycosis is not caused by black fungi. So I hope it was useful. If you like my content, please do like, share, subscribe, comment, and also press on the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. That's it, guys. Thank you.